outstanding amateur acts battle for a victory that only your votes can decide in just 30 seconds with Ted Mack and the Original Amateur Hour.
We have a ventriloquist from Falmouth, Massachusetts. Works as a custodian for the Falmouth School Department. Also a special police officer. Calls his two friends Butch and Eddie, and they call him Harold Crocker. Falmouth is out on Cape Cod, isn't it?
Yes, Mr. Mack. It's 10 miles from Hyannisport, Massachusetts, where the President-elect Kennedy lives.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Maybe your neighbor will vote for you.
I hope so, Mr. Mack, because I voted for him.
Well, I turn around to play a play, huh? Okay, let's see you and Butch and Eddie do your stuff.
Okay, fellas, what's this argument all about? Now, come on and kiss and make up.
I ain't gonna do it.
Why not?
Because I don't like Eddie anymore. What's this all about anyway? Eddie says he can sing better than I can. I can too. You cannot. I can too.
Okay, fellas, I'll settle this. Why don't the both of you sing together and we'll find out. Okay with me.
Me too. Music, Nitro.
Looking over a four-leaf clover that I overlooked before. Oh, first is
the sunshine, the second is the rain.
The third I'll be clover that lives in the lane.
Oh, there's no need
explaining the one remaining, the one that I adore.
Cause I'm looking
over a four-leaf clover that I overlooked before.
Here's the ventriloquist from Falmouth, Massachusetts.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you open and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they hung a star. Let's go on with the show. The costumes, the scenery, the makeup, the props, the audience that lifts you when you're down, the headaches, the heartaches, the backaches, the flops, the sheriff who escorts you out of town, the opening when your heart beats like a drum, the closing when the customers don't come. Get word before the show has started that your favorite uncle died at dawn. And top of that, your partner have parted. You're brokenhearted, but you go on. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Even with a turkey that you know will fold, you may be stranded out in the cold. Still, you wouldn't change it.
The whole world Hi there, Harold.
Hi there, Harold.
Hello, Harold. This is Jimmy Nelson.
And Danny O'Day.
And Thorthel. Right. And we're just saying hi to Harold Crocker.
What kind of a crock?
No, not a crock. C-R-O. We know how to spell it. Harold Crocker. Okay, we got it. Anyway, thanks for inviting us to be on your show, Harold. And we were sitting here, Danny and Farfel and I, just reminiscing about, a number of years ago when you and your family...
Yeah,
you came to visit us here at our home in Cape Coral, Florida.
That was nice. It was a hot day, but your family was cool.
Yes, they were. We had a good time. Anyway, it's always fun to see you at the Ventriloquist Convention, Harold. And I know your television show is a big hit.
Oh, I know that. Oh, yeah.
Sure. Yeah, right. And it's a pleasure to be on it with you. And also to talk to all of your viewers and your friends up there in Massachusetts. And
hey, your wife is from New England.
That's right. Betty is from Farmington, New Hampshire.
Does anybody know where Farmington is?
Well, it's a little town. Anyway, it's in New Hampshire. It's in New England, and we get up there every once in a while to visit. But in the meantime, we just wanted to come on your show because we heard it's very popular.
It is.
Right.
Yeah.
So Danny and Farfel and myself would like to do something that maybe your viewers will remember.
From the old days?
From the old days. Remember how it goes?
I certainly do.
Yeah.
May I have an A, please?
Yeah.
Hey! Did you get that, Farfel?
Hey!
That's close enough. Okay, here's how it went. Do you remember?
N-E-S-T-L-E-S. Nestle's makes the very best chocolate.
Remember that?
So do I, and I certainly do.
Yes, you do, Farfel. Anyway, from Jimmy Nelson,
Danny O'Dane, and Farfel.
Continued success to you, Harold, and we'll see you at the next Ventriloquist Convention. Okay?
It's all right.
No, that's somebody else's act.
New News Daybreak with Tanya Papanicolaou continues.
Well, I have two special guests with us this morning. This is Butch, and this is Harold Crocker. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Now, this is something. We're live television. Yeah, we're live.
We are live. That's right. Yep. Now, where did you two meet, Harold?
Well, we met quite a few years ago in Falmouth. This is a real replica of Paul Winchell's Jerry Mahoney years ago. And it has been signed and autographed by Paul Winchell because he's a friend of mine. And we've been working shows and for over 50 years now.
That's amazing.
Yep. Yeah, really have been. This is Tanya? Yeah, that's Tanya. She's cute, yeah. She wore a turtleneck, yeah. I heard her say that in the beginning of the show. I know you did. Isn't he great, huh? Yeah! Yeah, he's a sidekick of mine, and he's part of me. He's been with me for many years. Matter of fact, he's had the opportunity to appear for President Kennedy in Hyannisport.
Really?
And, for Caroline's birthday party when she was 10 years old. And we're going to do a little song that he sang for her, okay?
Okay, that'd
be great.
Are you
ready, Tanya?
I'm ready.
You sure? She's got a nice smile, hasn't she? Yeah, I know. She's good, better than you. I know. Be quiet, will you? This is great, great. We're on live television. Say hello to Nampa. Yeah, Nampa out there. This is Billy Shido. Yeah. What are they known for? They're known for potatoes. No. Yeah. Okay, you ready? Here's the song we did for the Kennedys at Hyannisport. Ready? Oh, he's got the whole world in his hands. He got the whole wide world in his hands. He got the whole world. Don't sit there just like that, Tanya. In his hands, he got the whole world in his hands. He's got the little bitty babies in his hands. He got the little bitty babies. Don't look at the camera, Hal. In his hands, he got the little bitty babies. In his hands, he got the whole world in his hands. He's got you and a brother. In his hands, he got you and a sister. What are you looking at? I'm looking to see if he'll let some of it. In his hands, he got you and a brother. In his hands, he got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world. In his hands, he got the whole wide world. In his hands, he got the whole world. In his hands, he got the whole world. We're getting there, Tanya. In his hands.
Very nice to both of you. That was impressive.
Great. See, it's the first time you see me, right?
I know. I was supposed to sing along there, I think.
How do you like talking to a doll?
I like it.
Yeah, I like dolls. But we call them figures.
Figures,
yeah. Really, yeah, he's a figure. I'm a figure, yeah.
Now, can I ask you, Harold, how you got started doing this?
We got started by watching, years ago, Paul Winchell with Jerry Mahoney.